Go send this to Dr.Witnesser. Go send it to people who hate on Juice WRLD. To me, Christians who do that kind of stuff, that's disgusting. Because that's not what God is. That's not who God is. That's not what Jesus died for. What's up, guys? It's Pastor Jordan. Today I'm reacting to some more Juice WRLD. You guys have been loving it. I have been loving it. I have continued to love Juice WRLD more as an artist. And all that said, I wanted to talk about a little video before I got into the reaction. So if you don't want to see this, you can skip ahead. But this dude, Dr. Witnesser, this guy who says he's a Christian, said a lot of stuff about Juice WRLD. And I just wanted to react to that and talk about that for a little bit because you guys have seen it. You guys were talking about it in the comment section. And I really want to talk about it because it really bothers me. So we're gonna watch it and we're gonna react to that first. So if you don't want to see that, you can skip ahead. But for those of you that want to know what I think about God and all the other stuff, and you come to my reactions for that stuff, this is for you for sure.
Juice WRLD, I would stay very far away from anybody's music who sits there and overdoses and dies from a seizure because of his drug overdose. Okay, clearly he did not have Christ in his heart. Clearly his music shows that. Clearly this the way what happened to him shows that.
Oh, that stuff makes me so mad, dude. I can't stand Christians who look at people who aren't Christians and expect them to act like Christians. Meaning, Juice WRLD, I don't know what he was, but I do know that he was genuinely searching for God, if his music is truly how he felt. When he talks about God, he's praying and he's saying, I need somebody to come save me because the drugs are not it anymore. The drugs are not doing it for me anymore. The lean is not doing it for me anymore. I'm dying slowly. The drugs are killing me softly. And he's begging God to come help him. And this dude is saying that Juice WRLD is trash for admitting that he had that struggle. And to me, that's disgusting. To me, Christians who do that kind of stuff, that's disgusting. Because that's not what God is. That's not who God is. That's not what Jesus died for. Juice WRLD was brutally honest about the effects of drugs. You could think of it like the Scared Straight program. If you guys have ever seen that show or you've ever heard of that kind of program where kids who are getting into lots of trouble and doing lots of bad things, they go to a jail and they talk to real prison inmates. They talk to real inmates who have been through it, who understand it, and who don't like it. Nobody likes going to prison. Nobody wants to go to prison. But these men are in there, and they realize that their actions have consequences, and it really messed them up. And so then they talk to these young kids and they say, you know what? Don't do what I did. Don't go down the path that I did, because once you get so far, there's no going back. And that's as it's as if he was saying to that prisoner, you know what? I would never look up to somebody like that. Cool. Why not? Why not? Who better to keep somebody out of jail than somebody who's been in jail and says, you know what? This is not what you want. Who better to keep somebody from doing drugs than somebody who has been addicted to drugs? That's why people who run AA meetings are former drug addicts. That's why people who run AA meetings are former alcoholics. That's why people who do the Scared Straight program are people who went to prison. They're felons. It's because they understand the idea of ruining your life. They understand that the path you're headed on is going to destroy you, and they want you to change it. In the last song that I reacted to by Juice WRLD, he was literally saying that. He was saying, don't give up. Don't stop. In his eyes, it would only be okay if Juice WRLD were to have quit and then been running the AA meeting, which to me is not true. To me, his lyrics and his words are just as genuine, whether or not he didn't make it out, whether or not he didn't survive, whether or not he didn't do it. My mom told me my entire life, don't do drugs, don't do this, don't do that. She cared about me. But where she was struggling doesn't mean she didn't care. It doesn't mean she didn't want me to not do drugs. My mom was never trying to make me do drugs. My mom never tried to get me to do drugs. My mom hated drugs with everything in her, more than I could ever hate drugs, because they ruined her life. People who have been down that road hate it more than you could ever understand. This guy will never hate drugs as much as Juice WRLD. That's why people look up to him. That's why people can look at him, even though he died in overdose, and say, you know what? I like his attitude. That's why I can look at him as a Christian, as a pastor, and say, if you listen to Juice WRLD's music, I'm okay with that. Because at least he's honest. At least he talks about how drugs ruined his life. This dude wants you to be perfect, and that's not what God wants. God, that's the thing. He expects people who aren't Christians to behave like he does, and they never will. And why would they? Why would they? If they don't know God the way that you do, why would you expect them to act the way that you do? I'm a pastor. I know God. I love God. But I will never bat an eye at somebody who cusses or somebody who does this or does drugs or drinks or if they don't know God, because why would I expect them to act like they do? Why would I expect them to change if they don't know where change comes from? This dude's wrong. This dude is wrong in the way that he's presenting this. And then people go and watch it and they think, man, pastors hate Juice WRLD. Man, Christians hate Juice WRLD. And I love Juice WRLD. Christians must hate me. When really all this kid is doing is listening to Juice WRLD because his parents did drugs or his brother did drugs and now they're gone. And he hates drugs, and Juice WRLD hates drugs, so he relates to it, and he gets to it, so he starts to look up to Juice WRLD. And then some pastor says that you are not a Christian, and you don't love God because you look up to Juice WRLD, and then that ruins it for them. They're never going to become a Christian, and they're never going to know that God loves them because of people like this. I don't know how he has a platform, I don't know how he has followers, but it's literally trash. It's trash. It's disgusting the way that Christians expect people who aren't Christians to act that way, and then judge them when they don't.
This really pains me to like know that there's a lot of young people out there in the world that are literally looking up to idols like Juice WRLD, looking up to a person that overdosed and died on drugs. I want your idol to be Jesus Christ, God. Have him as your idol, not Juice WRLD.
Yeah, that.
Shout out to Baiz, B-A-I-Z, for making this video with these clips. Do I want Jesus to be your idol? Yes, of course. But for different reasons. Jesus is the perfect example of what a human should be. He was anti-racial, anti-divisive, anti-sexism, all of that stuff. There's that like famous thread going around where, you know, we have this anti-rape culture now and we have this rape culture also, and they're like fighting against each other. And the woman love that Jesus said that if a woman is causing you to feel lust, to rip out your eye, not tell her to change her clothes, not tell her to put on more clothes, not tell her to do something different, but rip out your eye. Jesus was that kind of man. When they threw a naked woman in front of him and said that she was caught in the middle of having sex for money, he got on the men, not on her. He berated the men and said, you're all guilty. And then he told the woman, get up, sin no more. When the Jews were being racial and hateful to the Gentiles, who were a different culture and a different race of people, different color, different social status, Jesus literally spat on that. Jesus hated the idea of division based on of any social status or class. Jesus loved all people the same. Jesus would be somebody who Jesus is somebody who does away with racism and social class and social status and sexism and all of these other things. All people are equal in the eyes of Jesus. That's why I think Jesus should be your idol. But to say that Juice WRLD can't be your idol because he overdosed and died is stupid. Because all of Juice WRLD's music is contrary to the way that he died. Do you understand that this is a man who wrote songs against drugs and songs against and displaying his struggle? And then he didn't make it. He didn't win. But it doesn't make those songs any less true. He's not a hypocrite for that. That was in the middle of him struggling, in the middle of him trying to get over it. He died. But in the middle of all that, he wrote those songs, and they're powerful. You can't tell me that Juice WRLD is only worth looking up to if he had made it out alive and he was talking at some AA meeting. That's not true. All of his songs are valuable. All of his songs are true. And people look up to him because they can relate to him, because he came out of the struggle, because he understood drugs, he understood alcohol, he understood the life that most people are living. And this dude doesn't know anything about it. And that's why he can say all these things and put his foot in his mouth and sound so dumb. And give such a false representation of what God is and who God is. God can be in the middle of any kind of struggle. God can be in the middle of drugs, in the middle of alcohol, in the middle of addiction. And he's not going to bat an eye. Because he just wants you to come home. He just wants to love you. He just wants to tell you that you're worth it. He died for it. Jesus doesn't look at you in your best moment like this guy's talking about and say, you know what, you're worth dying for. Now people can idolize you. Now people can look up to you. Now you're worth it. Jesus looks at you in your very worst moment and says, you know what, I will still die for you. This is the moment that I'm dying for. I still love you completely. But that's not the God that he's presenting. There's another clip of him witnessing to some dude on Fortnite, and it's some little kid, and he's talking to him like he's an adult. Regardless of whether the things he's saying are true or not, any of it, regardless, put it all aside. The way that he's talking to some kid, as if he's an adult, you're not going to help anybody doing that. You're confusing him, and you're making him feel dumb, and it's stupid. The things that this guy's doing are stupid. They're not helping the kingdom. They're not helping God. They're not helping anybody. Just his YouTube channel. If you want to know who God is, read the Bible. Pray. Seek for him genuinely. Don't listen to some guy. Don't listen to me. Don't listen to some pastor. They can all help you in some ways, yes, but we're all fallible. We all make mistakes. None of us have seen God, you know, eye to eye, talked to him, spent enough time with him to understand everything about God. God is infinite. So if somebody's telling you they have all the answers, shut them off. If somebody's telling you they know everything about God, shut them off. Pray to him yourself. You don't need men to reach God. You don't need men to talk to God. You need Jesus Christ. That's it. You need Jesus Christ. No man can fully represent God except for Jesus, because he was God. I just wanted to talk about this video because I feel like most of my titles and thumbnails, I feel like people that don't click on them because of guys like this. Because they click on one and then it ruins it for the rest of us. I want to show you who God truly is. And so I'm only going to say things that I find in the Bible, things that I find in Scripture, things that I see Jesus doing. And I don't see Jesus doing that. I see Jesus not expecting people who don't know him to act like they do. I don't know. I'm going to put a thing in the beginning so that you can skip all that part if you want. So now we're here. We're going to react to some Juice WRLD. We're going to react to Lean Whitney. And at first I thought that sounded like just a party song. But the more that I think about it, I'm thinking of like Lean that you drink. And that stuff's harsh. But we're gonna get right into it.
God, grant me the serenity to accept the things that I cannot change, the courage to change the things I can, and the wisdom to know the difference.
Wasn't I just talking about it? Just describing AA meetings, and I had no idea that this was in the video. And you cannot believe me or believe me, that's fine, but I swear. I was just describing that Juice WRLD could be the speaker for an AA meeting if he was still alive. But people are only going to find that good enough if he had been alive. Regardless of whether his songs are not lined up with that, which is sucks, it's stupid. Don't judge him based on his death and his mistakes. Judge him based off of the message that he tried to give to the youth and to kids and to young people when he was alive.
All right, so we'll get into the big book and the 12 steps a little later tonight, but I always love to hear everyone's stories. Why don't you talk tonight?
Drugs got me sweating, but the room getting colder. Looking at the devil and the angel on my shoulder. Will I die tonight? I don't know. Is it over? Looking for my next high. I'm looking for closure. Laying with me, pot with me, get high with me. If you rock with me, smoke with me, drink with me. Fucked up liver with some bad kidneys.
That was a good line. He said, "Lean with me, pot with me." And then he said, if you rock with me, so he's saying like, if you're with me, you're going to be doing drugs. And he's also like, if rock is a drug, so he's saying rock with me. I don't know. That was a good wordplay. But honestly, dude, if you skip, go back and watch it because it's necessary. But literally, he's already describing how drugs are like demons on his back. Drugs are like things that just he uses as a crutch to get over things that he's feeling and dealing with so he doesn't have to feel them. But he's addicted. He's struggling. He says, am I going to die tonight? This man knew it was coming. He knew where he was headed. And so every song he talks about it saying, don't go the same direction. Don't do the same thing I'm doing. He's saying, if he could get out of it, he would have. I had somebody give me some hate the other day for asking you guys questions. He was like, why can't you just research it? And it's because I want to interact with you guys. I want to have relationships and connections with all of my viewers. That's why I answer every message I get. If I don't get to have a long conversation with you, I still try to at least answer it. But they said, why don't you just research it? That's why the country's so messed up. And I was like, dude, it's because I want to have a connection with my viewers. You guys told me last time on the last video that Juice WRLD was going to go to, was planning on going to rehab a week after his death date. He was going to go to rehab and then he died. That's so sad. But it shows that this man was trying to get off. This man was trying to get off that train. He was trying not to hit rock bottom. He was trying not to hit his end, but he knew where he was headed. That's why people can look up to him. So Dr.Witnesser, whatever the F, you don't know what you're talking about, dude. You don't know what you're saying, because this guy obviously did not like drugs. This guy obviously hated what he was doing. He was stuck in it, but you wouldn't understand drug addiction because you've never been a part of it. And if you have, then shame on you, because you should give this man some slack. You should understand a little bit better of what he's going through. That's why God is so connectable, because God understands every struggle. Because he's everywhere, always. He understands it. He doesn't look at you and judge you. He wants to die for you and love you. But that dude doesn't know anything about it. Juice WRLD was struggling. But every song he talks and he presents this good and positive message about not doing drugs by talking about how much they suck. Lane with me, pop with me, get high with me. If you rock with me, smoke with me, drink with me. Fucked up liver with some bad kidneys. Told her if I die, I'ma die young. Every day I've been getting fucked up. Finally know the difference between love and drugs. Shorty tell me I should really sober up. This shit ain't fiction, it's too real, too real. Fuck one dose, I need two pills, two pills. I'm looking for trouble, so I know I'm gonna fall. Exactly what I've been saying in every single video. He says, this isn't fiction, it's too real. Because in fiction, in the popular rap, you hear people talking about how fun drugs are, how cool it is, how hype it is, how lit it is. They talk about how great it is, and they're literally destroying their lives. And he says, nah, people are telling me to get sober, people are telling me to clean my life up, my organs are messed up, I'm gonna die young, I know it. How could anybody who listens to this think that he's somebody bad to look up to? No, doing everything he did might end up bad for you. But he didn't do it because he wanted to. He didn't do it because he thought it was cool. He didn't get addicted to drugs, and that's what he was. He was addicted. He wasn't just partying. The mainstream rappers you listen to who talk about how great drugs are, they're not addicted because they've never tried to quit. They don't know addiction. They just know giving themselves whatever they desire, cutting themselves off from any type of feeling. This dude was addicted because he was really trying to stop and was struggling to be able to stop. I don't know. I don't know how anybody could look at that and say, don't look up to him or don't listen to his music or...
Ring, ring, plug, hit my phone, perfect time, man.
What's your emergency?
I think my girlfriend overdosed.
Is she breathing? What's your address? Hello?
No, she's not breathing.
What's your name and your address?
I know I'm not right, but I'm not wrong. No, I'm not wrong. Girl, you hate it when I'm too high, but that's where I belong.
His videos are like a diary. It's like watching somebody die. He said the drugs are killing him softly, but his videos are, it's like watching somebody die over and over again. And the album name for his last album that they put out after he died, Legends Never Die. Like, that's a cool name because he's gone, but the fact that everything he's saying could be said as if he was dead but was given a chance to speak to everybody. I think that's what's crazy. Is that every song references his death. Every song references that drugs were going to kill him. Every song references that he wishes he could stop. Every song references the fact that he wishes it was over. Go send this to Dr.Witnesser. Go send it to people who hate on Juice WRLD. You're going to look at that. You're going to look at how every song he talks about his death, how every song he knew he was going to die soon. Not going to die eventually. Not the drugs were going to ruin his life. Going to die soon. And you're going to tell me that God was not impressing on his heart that he needed to stop. That God wasn't leaning into him heavy saying, if you don't slow down, I'm going to lose you. You're going to tell me that the Holy Spirit wasn't actively involved in this man's life. When he says there's an angel and a demon on each shoulder, he's not talking about his conscience anymore. He's talking about God trying to get to him and say, you know what, please stop. Just stop. And all the demons in his head and on his heart, whether they're real or just metaphorical, keeping him addicted and stuck on those drugs because he doesn't know how to get off of them because he needs them. He needs them so that he doesn't feel everything and it doesn't come crashing down on him. You're going to tell me everything that he's saying, the Holy Spirit wasn't speaking into his ear. No. God was there. This man was fighting some stuff. And this man was talking to God all the time and trying to fix it, trying to get it right, and he just couldn't. You know what? I mean, Juice WRLD's not my favorite artist. I listen to some of him, but I haven't listened to him the way that I have for these reactions. But I do it because you guys want to hear it, and I do it because you guys relate to him, and I do it because your situations are similar, a lot of you. And I care enough about you to take the time to understand why you like this music. Somebody like Dr.Witnesser won't do it because he doesn't care enough. He's just going to judge him, and he's just going to decide for him who he was and what he was about. I'm telling you that the Holy Spirit was in this man's life. Maybe he wasn't a Christian. Maybe he didn't know God fully yet. But the Holy Spirit was trying to get to this man. The Holy Spirit was whispering in this man's ear, and Satan didn't like it. 999. Satan did not like it. God was there, man. God was trying to reach this man. God was trying to talk to this man. And this man knew it. And so you get other fake Christians on here talking about don't ever look up to Juice WRLD. He's just some guy who didn't know God who overdosed. That's bull. That's bull. Because this guy has more depth and more realism than a lot of worship songs that I hear.
Fucked up liver with some bad chemists. Laying with me. Pot with me. Get high with me if you rock with me. Smoke with me. Drink with me. Fucked up liver with some bad chemist.
If you have lean with me, if you smoke with me, if you're popping pills with me, you're gonna mess up your liver and your kidneys just like me. But don't look up to this man, right? Whatever, dude. We need more Juice WRLDs in the world. I don't know how anybody can watch that and not want to cry. I don't know, man. 999. If you're struggling like that, or if you people in your family struggling like that, or any other man, or if you're just depressed like that, and you're looking for something to take it away, don't listen to other people who tell you that God's going to hate you, tell you that God should Jesus be your idol. I wish that would make the world a better place. But is it wrong to look up to somebody like this? Absolutely not. Is it wrong to look up to somebody who is an advocate for not doing drugs, for trying to get clean, and judge them and say that they're not somebody who kids should look at or listen to because they didn't make it? Absolutely not. Absolutely not. We don't listen to people who almost did drugs at AA meetings. We listen to people who did drugs and got better. We don't listen to people who almost became alcoholics. We listen to people who were alcoholics. We don't listen to people who almost went to prison to scare us straight. We listen to people who are in prison or have been to prison. Don't listen to somebody who doesn't know anything about drugs or anything about how God really is. It's perfectly fine to look up to somebody like this and also say that Jesus is your idol. It is perfectly fine to look up to somebody like this and say, you know what, I never want to do drugs ever. But this song goes hard. I don't know, guys. I hope that you like this video. I hope that you guys keep asking me to react. Please share these videos. Hit that bell, man, because you're not going to get any of my videos if you don't. Nobody wants to see these. The algorithm doesn't want you to see these. Mainstream people don't want you to see these. I'm not that popular, man. I'm not. But share it. Hit the bell so that you get my videos because they're all like this. And I will see you guys on the next video. Wife, I'll ease your pain and your strife. I'll be your reason to lie so you can eat with your eyes. Make love with me in your mind. I've been looking for you. I just wanted to help you. I know you're struggling right now. It's been a while since I felt you. I know just a thing to ease the strain. Let it overwhelm you. Just forget about your problems with the way that I touch you. I know you think about it. You open pictures.